So again, we are in the second class, and today's topic is double integration in polar coordinates, and the second is change of order of integration. The change of order of integration, this is one of the toughest topic so far in your syllabus, because most of the time we get trouble to draw the graphs and to take the limits. Limit is the priority basis here, because if we are not taking the limits properly, then we can't solve the sums. So for double integration in polar coordinates, here double integration in polar coordinates. We know better that polar coordinates is related to r and theta. Always, when there are polar forms, that means that polar form is always related to r and theta. So here, if note it down, if a region, if a region is bounded by r equal to f1 theta, r equal to f2 theta, and theta equal to alpha, and theta equal to beta, then the geometrical form of the polar integration can be represented with this diagram. So here, this part, this is the first part, and this is the second part. Here, this curve is denoted by r equal to f1 theta, and this r is equal to f2 theta. Now, we want to find out the area of this part. Here, r is equal to f1 theta, and this is r is equal to f2 theta. Please note it down. And this theta, here it is of alpha, and this theta, here it is of beta. Double integration in polar coordinates, if a region is bounded by r equal to f1 theta, this is the graph, and this r equal to f2 theta, if theta is equal to alpha and theta is equal to beta, then the shaded portion is represented by this. So we have to find out the area of this part. So the this shaded part can be represented so if we are getting the area of this small part, and after integration we will get the whole part of the area. So this is the geometrical interpretation of polar form. Now if we consider, here it is very simple, therefore area double integration, here we can write A. A stands for area. This is of f of r theta, and this is of dr d theta. In the case of polar form, always dr should be the first integration and d theta would be the second integration. But in Cartesian form, dx and dy, they can interchange. There it may be either of dx dy or dy of dx, but here it is always dr and d theta. So double integration f of r theta dr d theta, for theta limit is alpha and beta, for theta d theta limit is alpha and beta, and for r it is of f1 theta and this is of f2 theta. But the system is like the Cartesian form, but the system is like what we used in the Cartesian form, that is like that, similarly. How? So we can observe that if dr is here, then d theta is in waiting. If dr is here, then d theta is waiting. So limit of r1 and r2 should be in terms of waiting, that is of d theta. And d theta, it is a plane angle, that is of alpha and beta. This is of alpha and beta. So this is the concept of the polar form. This is the concept of the totally polar form. So geometrical interpretation and how we can represent the polar form to find out the area, this is here. Now we want to go to change of order of integration. This is obviously very tough, and you know, perhaps you are getting trouble in the case of change of order of integration. Everyone are getting problem here. So how we can come out from that problem, we want to see. Before going to the change of order of integration, we are taking one sum from your book, that is here say 0 to pi by 4 and 0 to root of cos of 2 theta, and here r y 1 plus r square whole square dr and d theta. Note it down. So 0 to pi by 4, this behaving as alpha and beta, and this is behaving as r1 and r2, and both r1 and r2 in terms of theta. So in case of this theta, it may be 0. It may be 0. Suppose any function of cos here and cos pi by 2, it is cos 90 is equal to 0. So this is equal to 0 to pi by 4, and this is of 0 to root of cos of 2 theta r by 1 plus r square whole square, and it is of dr and d theta. Now we will write here, let 1 plus r square equal to, you can't write here theta because theta is already here, so you will give its other name as d. So 1 plus r square equal to d, therefore 2r dr it is equal to dt. Therefore, r dr, it is equal to dt by 2. Now, the most important point, when variable changes, that means limit will also change simultaneously. Then, when r is equal to 0, then t equal to 1. And when r is equal to root of cos of 2 theta, then t equal to 1 plus cos of 2 theta. 1 plus cos of 2 theta, because root of cos 2 theta square is equal to cos 2 theta. Now the next part, which I am solving here. So it is of 0 to pi by 4. Now it is, in place of 0 you will write 1, and in place of this you will write 1 plus cos of 2 theta. rdr, that stands for dt by 2, then it is of dt by 2, 1 by 2 constant to be taken out, and 1 plus r square, that is t, then it is of t square, and remaining is d theta. So very important, sir. Now 1 by 2, 0 to pi by 4, and here it is of, its integration is minus 1 by t, because 1 by t square stands for t to the power minus 2 dt. Its integration is t to the power minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1, that is minus 1 by t. So it is of minus 1 by t, and here we will write this is 1, and 1 plus of cos 2 theta and d theta. Now these minus we will take out. So it is of minus 1 by 2, 0 to pi by 4. Now it is 1 plus cos 2 theta, and lower limit is minus 1 of d theta. So this is minus half 0 to pi by 4. Now here it is of 1, say 1 minus 1 minus of cos 2 theta by 1 plus cos 2 theta d theta. These and these will cancel out. So now it is minus of minus plus 1 by 2, 0 to pi by 4, cos of 2 theta by 1 plus cos of 2 theta d theta. 1 plus cos 2 theta, 1 plus cos 2 theta, it is equal to 2 of cos square theta. You know better, 1 plus cos 2 theta equal to 2 cos square theta. So here, this is a 2 cos square theta. So here also you can do it from here. From here you can do it without solving this part. Here it is of minus 1 by 2, 0 to pi by 4, and this is 1 by, it is of 2 cos square theta minus 1 of d theta. So now this minus 1 by 2 and minus 2, it is minus 1 by 4. This minus 1 by 2 and 2 is 1 by 4. Now here it is 0 to pi by 4. 1 by cos square theta is equal to second square theta d theta. This is one part, and minus of minus, this is of plus 1 by 2 of d theta, and this is 0 to pi by 4. Now, integration second square theta is equal to tan theta. Integration second square theta is equal to tan theta. So, it is minus 1 by 4. Here it is of tan theta and 0 to pi by 4 plus 1 by 2 theta 0 to pi by 4. So now minus 1 by 4 tan pi by 4 is 1 minus tan 0 is 0, and here it is 1 by 2 pi by 4 minus 0. So we can write minus 1 by 4 plus of pi by 8. And further, if it is LCM, we will take 8, 4 to the 8, so it is of pi minus 2 by 8. This is what should be the unit? Square unit. Always unit is the square unit. So now, after this concept, we want to move to the change of order of integration. Change of order of integration. For change of order of integration, this concept is very, very important, and once you pay concentration here in this topic to get the area by changing the order of integration. It's a very vital question for the exams. So now, suppose we are given integration R stands for region and A for area. What you can write? So here it is of f of x, y, and here it is dx and dy. The main concept here, and for dx, it is of x1 equal to phi 1 y, and it is of x2, it is equal to phi 2 y, and dy is any constant, that is a to d. Now we have to evaluate this integration by using the change of order. Change of order means we have to change the order. Here order is dx dy. Here order is dx dy. That means we have to solve this sum by interchanging dy dx. So it is not an easy task. Double integration, fxy, no changes are there in the function, only dx to be replaced by dy and dy to be replaced by dx. It means here in the first case, if the bounded part was like this, here it is dx, means it is horizontal strip was in number 1, and for dy, perpendicular strip, it was in number 2. In the initial sums, we are observing that here dx dy, for dx we know that horizontal strip would be as 1, and then for dy, perpendicular strip. But here when we are changing, that means in this case, for the same sum, here dy is number 1, so this to be replaced, it would be number 1, and this horizontal strip would be 2. And due to that, limit would be changed here, and that limit we will find out drawing the drawing the curve through the limits. The curve what we are getting here, that is through the limits, not through the function. So through on the basis of limits, we will draw the curve and then we will find out the limits and then we have to solve. So dx stands for horizontal strip, dy stands for vertical strip, and when we are going to change from dx to dy, that means the change of order immediate comes, and in that case it should be dy dx. So first strip should be converted to vertical and then it is horizontal. According to this, if we take a sum, then how we can solve it? Right now, take a sum, that is 0 to 2, 0 to 2, 0 to 4 minus x square, x e to the power 2y by 4 minus y, and here it is of dy dx. At the very first moment, we should check the sum, whether the sum is in order or not. This is the first point. During solving the multiple integral, this point is very, very essential. So what we will check? We will check here, dy is here and dx is in waiting. That means first limit should be in terms of x. Yes, here it is in x. That means sum is totally okay and we can find out this. So first of all, you will write down the sums. Once again, this is 4 minus x square, x e to the power 2y, sorry, this limit would not be here. And this is of 4 minus y, but dy dx should be converted to dx and dy. This we will write down the functions and changing the order, that is dy dx should be converted to dx dy. Now we will wait to decide the limit, and that concept is here very, very important. So please note it down. Here it is dy, for dy it is y1. So here we will write here y1 equal to 0 and y2 it is equal to 4 minus x square. After that, x1 equal to 0 and x2 equal to 2. You know better, after this term we write in general. After that we write in general. So in general, when we are writing in general, at that time there would not be any y1, y2, x1, x2. So here it would be y equal to 0, y equal to 4 minus x square, and x equal to 0 and x equal to 2. So after that, we are observing here that all the y0, x0, x2, these are all numerical values, but only function is here, that is y equal to 4 minus x square. So that means we will draw the graph of the 4 minus x square. Next point, you will write here for y equal to 4 minus x square. 4 minus x value kya hai? We will draw the box here, this x and y. Now, x is 0, y is 4. X is 0, y is 4. Now, thereafter, last day I asked you, when x square or y square is there, we will take the value in plus minus 4. So, here we will take the value of plus minus 4. So, it is of say plus minus 1. Plus minus 1 it is 1. 4 minus 1 it is equal to 3. Then it is plus minus 2. It is 4 minus 4 equal to 0. And this is enough to draw the graph. So, now we will draw the quadrant. First of all, we will take x 0, y 4 here. Then it is x of plus 1, x of plus 1, y equal to 3, and x is minus 1, here it is 3. Then thereafter, it is 2, 0, and this is of minus 2, 0. So that means car would be like this. We have drawn the graph. Now, y equal to 0 means this will indicate y equal to 0, x equal to 0, that means this will indicate x equal to 0, x equal to 2 means x equal to 2 and 0. So, x equal to something is parallel to y axis, it is of x equal to 2. So, from all the sides, the curve is bounded by x equal to 0, y equal to 0, x equal to 2, and it is of y equal to 4 minus x square. So, your shaded part would be this. This would be the shaded part, and you have to find out the area of this part. So, for further calculation, now we are observing that dx is the first. That means our streak would be parallel to x-axis. This is the main concept. This is the main concept. Slow but steady win there is. So, that means here it is x is equal to 0, here it is x equal to 0, and from here we will get in terms of y, that means we will write here, since y equal to 4 minus x square, therefore x square equal to 4 minus y, therefore x is equal to root of 4 minus y. So now we have shifted to the limit, that is root of 4 minus 1. And now dy is concerned. For dy, this would be the horizontal strip. And for horizontal strip, I asked you that minimum to maximum. That means minimum base, here it is 0. And here this coordinate is 0, 4. This is of 0, 4 and this is of 0, 0. So, for y, it is y1, y2. That means the final limit is 0 to 4. This is the main concept from shifting, for the shifting of from one form to the other form in the case of change of order of integration. And most of the cases, students are get troubled to find out this limit. Now, we have to solve this 0 to 4. As because dx is concerned, that means e to the power y 0 to root of 4 minus y, e to the power 2y y 4 minus y is totally constant. Is totally constant to be taken one side and it is of dx and then it is of dy. So 0 to 4 e to the power 2y by 4 minus y, it is of x square by 2 and here it is of 0 to root of 4 minus y, 4 minus y of dy. This part is here, x dx means x square by 2 and the limit is 0 to root of 4 minus y. Now 0 to 4 e to the power 2y by 4 minus y, 1 by 2 to be taken as constant and here it is x square, that means it is of 4 minus y and lower limit is 0 of dy and this 4 minus y and this 4 minus y will cancel out. So finally, it is of 1 by 2. Now, integration 0 to 4 e to the power 2y dy. So it is 1 by 2 e to the power 2y by 2 and here it is of 0 to 4. Then 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 is 1 by 4. E to the power 4 into 2 is 8 minus lower limit e to the power 0 is 1. So your answer is e to the power 8 minus 1 by 4 divs square units.